Okay, standard score or z-score. What is standard scores or z-score? It reveals how many units of the standard deviation the raw score is above or below the mean and allow us to compare the results to different normal distributions. So we just discussed the normal distribution and its properties. So as you have noticed, the mean is located at the center of the normal curve. And at the right side of the mean, there are positive numbers. So positive standard deviation away from the mean. And on the left side of the mean, we have negative 1, 2, 3 standard deviation away from the mean. So the quantity z-score represents the distance between raw score and the population mean in units of the standard deviation. That is why we have on the right side of the mean, we have mean plus 1 standard deviation. And on the left side, we have mean minus standard deviation and so on. So we have to remember this. So the z-score is negative when the raw score is below the mean. So meaning to say, the z-score is located at the left side of the mean. Okay. Next, the z-score is positive when the raw score is above the mean. So, it will be positive if it is located at the right side of the mean. Take note that the mean is located at the center of the normal curve. So, z-score will be zero when the raw score is the same as the mean. So, when we are talking about standard normal distribution, mean is zero. So, when z-score is zero, meaning to say it is located at the center of the normal curve. Okay, how will you compute the z-score? So, of course, you have to use these following formulas. So, when we are talking about population, you have to use this one. Okay, that x here is what we call the raw score. Mu is population mean and standard deviation. We have the lowercase sigma. So you have x minus population mean over the standard deviation. If we are talking about the sample, first, you have to use this as symbol. Okay, so same formula. You have the raw score minus mean over the standard deviation. For example, okay, you have your book. You can open your book on page 23. So I will answer number 1 and 2 for the example. Okay, for number 1, look at number 1. So the given is x is equal to 50, meaning to say x will be the raw score. S is the standard deviation, and that is 5, and x bar is 40, so that is the sample mean. Okay, so all you have to do is use the formula. So for number 1, those are the given, and then the formula that we will use is z is equal to x minus x bar over s. So we just substitute the given. Your x is 50, and then minus 40 over s is 5. So, perform the operations to get z. So, 50 minus 40 is 10 over 5. So, 5. So, 10 divided by 5. That will give you z is equal to 2. So meaning to say, the Z value is, or Z score is 2. For, that is for number 1. Next. Number 2. Okay, so number 2, we are talking about a population. So, these are the given. So, X is 40. Then, standard deviation is 8 and mean is 52. So, you have to use this formula. Z is equal to X minus mu, which is the population mean, over lowercase sigma, the standard deviation. So, substitute the given, we have 40 as X, minus mean is 52, okay, divided by 8. So, as you have noticed, Z will now become negative because 40 minus 52 is negative 12, divided by 8, and Z will become negative 1.5. And this will be the Z score of number 2. Meaning to say, the Z score is located below the mean. It's because that is negative. So try to answer number 3, 4, and 5. Another example. Okay, look at example number 1. Okay, student A got 65 plus A's mean score is 50 with a standard deviation of 5. What is student A's z-score? So we are looking for the z-score of student A. First, you have to identify the given. So, what are the given? Okay, 65 here is the row score. So, X is 65. Next, mean score is 50. Therefore, we have mu, which is equal to 50. And then, standard deviation of 5. So, lowercase sigma is equal to 5. So, you have to use the formula again. Z is equal to X minus mu over the standard deviation. So, substitute the given. We have 65 minus 50 over 5. So, what will be the Z? So, 65 minus 50 is 15 over 5. Then Z is 3. Okay. So, meaning to say, student A's score is 3. And it is located above the mean. So, try to answer example number 2 for your practice. Okay, next. Example number 3. Consider a random variable that is normally distributed where the population mean is 40, standard deviation is 4, and the row score is 50. Find the value of Z and interpret its computed value. Okay. So, all you have to do is identify the given. Okay, so we have the population mean, which is 40. Therefore, you have mu is equal to 40. Next is standard deviation of 4. Look at this. Okay, so lowercase sigma is equal to 4. Then, row score is 50. Therefore, X is equal to 50. Then, use the formula again. Z is equal to X minus mu over the standard deviation. Substitute the given, we have 50 minus 40 over 4. Perform the operations, we have z is equal to 50 minus 40 is 10 over 4. So 10 divided by 4, that will give you z is equal to 2.5, and that is positive. So this is the z score. So how will you write the conclusion? The z-score is 2.5. It means that the row score is 2.5 units above the mean value. So that will be the conclusion for this problem. Next example. Okay, example number 4. Based on a survey, the mean weekly allowance of the grade 11 students of Oran Academy is 750 pesos with a standard deviation of 100 pesos. Assuming that the weekly allowance is normally distributed, what is the z-score of a student with a weekly allowance of A, 950 pesos, and B, 600 pesos? Okay, so you have to find the z-score. So we'll start with letter A. First problem, A. 950 here is the weekly allowance of the student. Meaning to say, that will be the variable x. So x is 950 pesos. And then, students, mean weekly allowance is 750. So, meaning to say, mean is 750. And then, standard deviation is 100. So, standard deviation is 100. Okay, you have to use the formula again to find the z. Okay, so that is x minus mean. So, we have 950 minus 750 over 100. Okay, solve or perform the operations. 950 minus 750, you will get 200 divided by 100. So, z is 2. So, what will be the conclusion? The z-score of a student with a weekly allowance of 950 pesos is 2. Next, letter B. What if, for letter B, the given weekly allowance of the student is 600? Meaning to say, x here is 600. Okay? Same given mean and standard deviation. So, you have to substitute the given to the formula. So, z is equal to x is 600 minus mean is 750 over the standard deviation 100. 600 minus 750, that will give you negative value, which is negative 150 over 100. So, negative 150 over 100, this will give you negative 1.5. So, this is the z value. So, what will be the conclusion? The z score of a student with a weekly allowance of 600 pesos is negative 1.5. Next example. Example number 5. Assuming that the scores of grade 11 students in statistics and probability in their third quarter test are normally distributed with a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 5. If the z-score of a student is 2, find his real score. Okay. So, in this case, you have to find the real score, which is, we use x, variable x, for the real score. So, the formula is z is equal to x minus mean over the standard deviation. Since we have to find the real score, we have to manipulate the formula. Okay. To find the raw score, the formula will be x is equal to mean plus z score times the standard deviation. So we will use this formula to find the raw score. So let's identify the given. Okay. Mean is 50, therefore mu will be 50, and then the standard deviation is 5. So we have standard deviation of 5, and the z-score is given, which is positive 2. So z is 2. Okay, looking back to the formula, so we will use this formula to find the raw score. We just substitute the given. So we have 50 plus z is 2 and then standard deviation is 5. Perform the operation. So 50, 2 times 5 is 10. So 50 plus 10 is 60. So this will be the raw score. What will be the conclusion? The raw score of a student with a z-score of 2 is 60. Last example number 6. Based on the table below, who performed better, Oliver or Miggy? Assume a normal distribution from two different classes. So we have the table here, given the raw score, mean, standard deviation. Therefore, you have to find the z-score of Oliver and Miggy. So who performed better? Is it Oliver with the raw score of 75 or Miggy with the raw score of 58? Okay, so we'll start with Oliver. Okay, Oliver, raw score is 75. Mean is 65. And standard deviation is 4. Using the formula, so which is x minus mean over the standard deviation, substitute the given, we have 75 minus 65 over 4. Okay, 75 minus 65 is 10, divided by 4, z is positive, so that is 2.5. So the z-score of Oliver is 2.5. Next, for Miggy. Okay, Miggy raw score is 58. Mean is 52. And standard deviation of 2. Using the formula again to find the z. So z is 58. Minus 52 divided by 2. Perform the operations. 58 minus 2 is 6 divided by 2. That will give you 3. Positive 3. Now, after you solve the z-score of Oliver and Miggy, you have to compare So, as you have noticed, 3 is greater than 2.5. So, what will be the conclusion? Who performed better? The z-score of Miggy is larger than the z-score of Oliver. Therefore, Miggy performed better than Oliver. That's